honors us all the days of our life. We thank you for that that you have made available to every saint of God. Every person that have been born again is entitled to see Jesus. Yeah, we must see him. Do you understand the things of God in the spirit realm? We must see Jesus. Amen. He's not dead. He's alive. Amen. And you and I are his witnesses right here in this present evil world. Amen. We're witness to his death, his burial, and his resurrection. Amen. Because we died with Christ. When Christ died, we died. The believer died. Every believer that believes in Jesus Christ is already dead to sin. All he have to do is continue to believe that. Have faith in God. Trust in God. Trust in his word. Trust in his power. Trust in his glory. Every person that ever gets born again from up above, God has freed him through his son, Jesus Christ, from sin. Sin and death. This new man will not even taste death. He won't know nothing about death. Death has been abolished in the person of the Lord Jesus Christ for every believer. Jesus Christ has abolished death and brought life and immortality to light through the gospel. And that is what God has given us and sent us out to preach, is the gospel of Christ, the gospel of the kingdom of Almighty God. Jesus came to earth to set up a heavenly kingdom right here in the heart of the believer. Amen. So the kingdoms of this world, they don't belong to God, and they're coming down. Amen. Through the gospel that we preach, through your understanding of the word of God, every one of his children that have been born again from up above, they have an understanding heart. He has put a new heart in you, a new heart inside of me. Amen. He has taken the stony heart out of our flesh and put within us an heart of flesh. Amen. Praise God. Father, touch somebody's heart today. Heal, deliver, and set free those that are seeking after Christ. We got to walk in the spirit. We can't walk in the flesh and find God. You have to walk by faith and not by sight. And the just shall live by faith. Come on up, Sister Duff. Talk to us a while. Amen. We know that God has given you something very precious to give to his people. It's called his word. Jesus Christ, being God's word made flesh, dwelt among us, and we have beheld his glory, right? We're beholding Jesus. He's the man in the glory. Amen. Hallelujah.
I might have to give you a little more voice. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. It's a blessing, an honor, and a benediction to be here tonight. That the Lord has given us another day that we can lift up his name and honor him and praise him. And speak a word that will bless his people. And he's the one that's given us the word. Amen. And I'm going to say this. We got to learn how to talk God's language. We've been saying that for months. We got to speak the language of God and stop speaking the language of the world. And it says here, nowhere does the Bible teach that if you just believe in your heart, you'll get an answer. It teaches that if you believe it with your heart and say it with your mouth, you shall have whatsoever you say. This is one of the secrets of confession. Confession is important. That's why you need to say what the word says. There's power in the word. And what are you saying tonight? What are you confessing? Whatever you are confessing, that is what you are possessing. Because you have what you say. The Bible says that we have what we say. Jesus said, you have what you say. And we have to be very careful what we say. He says, there is no faith without confession. Listen, there is no faith without confession. Did you get it? Say it. There is no faith without confession. All right?
Amen.
It says that with your mouth, you are either going to give God dominion over you, or you're going to give Satan dominion over you.
Wow.
Now, if you speak God's word, or speak his language, you're giving him dominion.
That's right.
That's your confession. But if you speak the words of the world, or whatever you're feeling or seeing, then that's what you're going to get.
Sure.
You give the devil dominion over you. So it's two powers there.
Thank you, Jesus.
But the devil can't do nothing to God's people without their permission. You've got to say something that's not the language of God in order for the enemy to take dominion.
That's right.
Our confession is so important. He said, you're going to give Satan dominion over you, or you're going to give God dominion over you. Quit talking the devil's language and start talking God's language. as of tonight, said, I am not going to speak the language of the devil. I am going to speak the language of God. And the language of God is the word of God. And I have power in my confession. All right. Now that wasn't hard, was it? Just remember, you got to continue. It's a continuation in making your confession. Believe in your heart, confess with your mouth. And whatever you believe in your heart, that's what's going to come out of your mouth. Because the Bible said, out of the heart comes the issues of life. And if I believe that God is right and his word is right, then that's what I'm going to speak. Because I want to give God dominion over me. And you should want to give him dominion over you.
Amen.
And over your family.
Amen.
Whatever you speak about your family, that's what will take place. If God's given you power to bless your family, then you need to take the power of that word and bless your family. It makes no difference what they're doing, what they're saying. God has given us power because we're serving him. We're his children, and he's given us the word to pray a blessing on our children. And it will come to pass. You can look in the Bible, in under the old covenant, those men blessed their children. And when they got ready to leave the earth, they called them all in, and they prayed a blessing on them. It didn't say they were doing what they were supposed to do, all of them, but he blessed them. The Father blessed the children. He prayed a blessing. And this is the time. If it ever was a time, it's a time for you to and not curse. So what are you confessing today? Just think about it. This is something the Lord wants you to think about. Just that. What are you confessing? What is your confession? Are you confessing the word? Are you confessing unbelief and doubt and fear? It's time for us to speak the word. And I'm gonna give you some. We had some confessions. Do you all remember the gospels?
Yes.
How many still got their gospels? You know what it said? It said confess them 3 times a day. Now, if you're talking about a powerhouse, if you had, from the time that you got these to right now, you'd be a powerhouse of confession, of confessing these words. I mean, the devil couldn't get you to say nothing else, because there's power in the word. And you confess them until they manifest. Manifest means until they show up in your life. Amen? And we need to move in the power at this hour. And it's all going to depend on what we're confessing. What are you confessing? All right. The first confession is for wisdom and guidance. Confess these scriptures daily. For wisdom and guidance. Confess these scriptures daily. The first one is Colossians 3:9-10. I want you to say it after I say it. I do not lie. For I have put off the old man with his deeds. And I have put on the new man, which is renewed in knowledge after the image of him that created him. So we know who that is that created us, don't we? God our Father created us. And so we done put off the old man and his deeds. And we done put on the new man. So now we're walking in true holiness and true righteousness. And then John said, 16:13, the Spirit of truth has come. He guides me into all truth. He does not speak of himself. That he hears, that he speaks. And he shows me things to come. See, I'm here tonight speaking that I do know. Nothing else, nothing more, nothing less. Just speaking what God has shown me. And what is being fulfilled in me. And whatever you've got, you can give it. If you haven't got it, you can't give it. You can't give something you haven't got. Amen. Now, you can get up and you can tell people about holiness. You can tell people about righteousness and all. And if you don't have it, you're just blowing in the wind. It doesn't mean anything. But God will show people the results of what you're saying in your life. He will show it. Amen. Okay, Proverbs 3:5-6. I trust in the Lord with all my heart, and I lean not unto my own understanding. In all my ways, I acknowledge him, and he directs my path. Is that true? That's a powerful confession. And if you are doing that, making that confession, then it's fulfilled in your life. What are you confessing today? What is your confession? Is it the word of God? Or is it the words of the world? The power of God is in the word of God. And he is opening up the word to us tonight. And we're testifying to what we have received from the Lord. And in that word, he also was showing me, as I begin to look at these confessions, he was showing me the healing power of this word. The word, he sent his word and he healed us from all of our diseases and all of our distresses. He sent his word and healed us. Who is the word? Jesus. Jesus is the word of God. And he came and he lived and he healed the sick and he raised the dead and he gave sight to the blind. And the lame got up and walked. And the deaf heard. The power of the word. Because he was the word. And now he's making us in his image. And in his likeness. That we will go and speak the word. Only learning to speak the language of God. This is God's word that we're talking about tonight. And it is God. Because God sent Jesus. He wrapped himself as a matter of truth. God wrapped himself up in that little flesh. And came down to this earth. To save man. He had that plan before the foundation of the world. Because he knew all what was going to happen with man. He knows the end from the beginning. And he knows the beginning from the end. That's the word, the power of the word. And he spoke it. He spoke those things that were not as though they were. And they came to pass. And this is the hour now where we're coming into. Speaking those things that are not as though they were. And they are. Amen. I'm talking about the power of healing. I'm talking about what confession are you making today? Speaking the language of God. This is what we're supposed to do. And the language of God is this word here. Not what we think. Not what somebody told us. But what God told us. And he backs it up with his word. We can be assured that what we're speaking is God's language. When it comes out of the word. Healing is the children's bread. God sent healing to us. Jesus took the stripes on his back for our healing. They beat him unmercifully. And he said, "Why don't you believe what I've done for you? Why don't you say what I say? Why don't you believe me? Why don't my people believe me? And make the right confession." I hear so many times we say, we're changing our language. But we've got to do it. It's time to stop fixing to do something and do it. God is in the now. Now faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. He moves in the now. And faith, your confession, brings faith. It's power. You can believe all you want to, but if you never make a confession, then your faith won't work. Believe in your heart and confess with your mouth. Believe in your heart and confess with your mouth. This is the word. What are you confessing? Are you confessing blessing? Are you confessing healing? Are you confessing deliverance? God's people making the wrong confession. Oh, I'm so sick. You hear what you say. It doesn't seem like much. But you have the power of your Father in your mouth, in your tongue. And when you say something, it's going to take place. We got to realize who we are in Christ Jesus. What authority we have. And speak it. Speak the word only. Speak the word only. Make your confession the language of God. We're in the hour where we need to speak the word more than we've ever spoken before. It doesn't make no difference to me what people think about me. It really doesn't. Wherever he tells me to pray for somebody, I'm going to pray for them. And you know, a lot of people appreciate that. Maybe some don't, but it doesn't really matter. It doesn't really matter. Those that believe will receive and get what they ask for. Making the right confession. Power in your word. See, it doesn't take a whole lot. Just use what you got. So, I want a whole lot of faith like so-and-so, sister so-and-so, or brother so-and-so. Use what you got. And it'll increase. If God's given you something, use it. Don't let the devil tell you that you ain't got nothing. Use it. Speak it. Don't be afraid. God didn't give you the spirit of fear, but power. Power of the Holy Ghost. Love, the love of God. And that sound mind is the mind of Christ. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for your word. Thank you for your power. Thank you for the authority. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for your healing. Thank you, Jesus. We believe and we receive. We confess and we possess. And now it's time to take back that the enemy has stolen away from you. Then he said there would come a time that the enemy was going to have to give up. Well, we got to speak it. He ain't going to give up until we speak it. When we start speaking with the authority that God has given us in the name of Jesus, it's going to happen. It's taking place right now in the atmosphere. The angels are going and setting people free. Binding up the brokenhearted. Setting at liberty those that are bruised. Because we're preaching the acceptable year of the Lord. And it's here now. It's here now. Healing is here now for you. And deliverance is here now for you. All you got to do is step in the water. Step in the water. It's being trouble. It's trouble tonight. And all you got to do is step in. And you'll be healed. From the crown of your head to the soles of your feet. Right out to the ends of your fingertips and your toe tips. The power of God is moving. It's moving in the atmosphere. He's bringing healing to souls. He's saving souls. He's binding up your heart. He's setting at liberty those that are bruised. The Spirit of God. Like he moved in the beginning on the face of the deep. And he stepped out and he said, let there be light. Hallelujah. And some say he said, light be. And it was. Well, he's saying the same thing now. Light be. And it is. Salvation for those that need salvation. Deliverance for those that need deliverance. Healing for those that need healing. And those that been hurt years and years and years and haven't forgiven. You got to forgive. People of God, you got to forgive. It's healing. It's a healing balm in forgiving. You set yourself free. You set yourself free. It's power in forgiving. It makes no difference what somebody has done to you. Jesus looked out over the people when he was hanging on the cross and all that they did to him. He said, Lord, forgive them, for they know not what they do. You got to say the same thing. Lord, forgive them, for they know not what they do. It's time to gird up your loins and walk as people of God. Be that light that God called you to be. And confess the right thing the world is looking for. The manifestation of the sons of God. And it's time for the sons to manifest. And how will you manifest? With your mouth. Saying who you are. Not being ashamed to say you are a son of God. And I have been made the righteousness of God in Christ. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. It's time to move out. Move out. Move up. Time is winding up. Perilous times are here. Men are lovers of themselves more than they are of God. You can look around tonight and see, where are the people? Where are the people? Thank you, Jesus. We love the Lord. We love the Lord with all our heart. And we're going to walk in his way. We're going to confess the right confession. And we're going to bless his people. Because he told us to bless and curse not. Yes, he did. He told us to bless and curse not. And that's exactly what we're doing. Grace is here, church. You know who grace is? You know what grace's name is? Jesus. Jesus. He's here. He's here. He's moving. He's moving. He's healing the sick. He's healing somebody right now. You know what he showed me? He said, if you'll speak what I tell you to speak, he said, I'll move on my people in a miraculous way. I'll put my hands on them. Yes, Lord. They won't need no flesh to touch them. The power of my word is going to do it. Hallelujah. And that's what he's doing right now.
Yes, Lord. Yes.
Amen. From this night forth, yes, things going to be different in your home.
You,
Mother Porter. Word from the Lord. From this night forth, it's going to be a change in your home. God's stirring the nest. He heard your prayers. He's seen your tears. And he's come to see about you. Yes, he is. He's moving right now. Yes, he is. He's healing the sick. He's raising the dead. Those that are dead in trespasses and sin. He told us that's what we would do. We're going to do greater works than these, he said. What were the great works? He came, he was raising the dead dead. But he was saying, we're going to raise the spiritual dead. And the spiritual lame. And the spiritual death. That word is going to go out and grab them. Open up their deaf ears. They're going to hear the voice of God for the first time. And they're going to be able to walk towards him. And they're going to have the love in their heart. Because he's putting it there. The word has come. The word has come. to deliver you. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. 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 Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Sissy, that's getting ready to come, a turnaround in your life. A turnaround. Great power and glory is coming to your home. God is going to move in a miraculous way because you love him and you're seeking him. He said, continue to pray. Continue to believe. And hold on to the horns of the altar. Don't give up. He said, I'm moving for you. I've come to see about you. I know what you're going through. I'm right there with you. I'll never leave you nor forsake you. Just believe it. Just believe it. Just believe it. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. He's healing you too. He's healing your body. Thank you, Jesus. 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 Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. 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 Oh, Father, we thank you. We thank you for your word, Lord Jesus. We thank you for your word. We thank you for sending your word and healing us from all of our diseases and all of our distresses. Oh, we're yours, Lord. We surrender all. All to you we surrender. Thank you, Jesus. 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 Brother Benny. Come. Thank you, Jesus. 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 The Lord said to tell you some things you've been praying about, you ain't told nobody. But you've been believing and trusting. He says, come in the past. Just don't give up. Hold on. He said, he's there with you. He'll never leave you nor forsake you. Amen. He said, just rejoice. Rejoice. And make the right confession. Woo! Glory. Thank you, Lord. Come on, brother. You got something you want to share with us tonight? Thank you, Jesus. 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 It's going to be a change here at this place, he said. It may not seem like it, but you're going to see little by little changes in our little place here. Amen. You're going to see the power of God moving in miraculous ways like you've never seen it here before. So just look for it. It's going to happen. Amen. Because I'm speaking what he's telling me. What I hear him say, that's what I'm saying. What I see him do, that's what I'm going to do. Amen. From this night forth, you can say, Sister Duff, going crazy. Well, I am a fanatic for Jesus. And I'm going to do what he tell me to do, when he tell me to do it, and how he tell me to do it. Amen. Give Jesus a hand clap. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Just continue on. I've got with a little word from the Lord from the book of Colossians chapter 1. Colossians chapter 1. Paul says, beginning at verse number 9, Colossians chapter 1, verse 9, he said, "For this cause we also, since the day we heard it, do not cease to pray for you and to desire that you be filled with the knowledge of his will in all wisdom and spiritual understanding, that you might walk worthy of the Lord unto all pleasing, being fruitful in every good work, and increasing in the knowledge of God, strengthened with all might according to his glorious power, unto all patience and suffering with joyfulness, giving thanks unto the Father, which has made us meet to be partakers of the inheritance of the saints, who has delivered us from the power of darkness and translated us into the kingdom of his dear Son." Amen. Paul prays in verse number 11. He prays that the church be strengthened. I mean, how many of you know we need strength tonight? He prays that the church be strengthened with all might according to his glorious power. In other words, he prayed that the strength be strengthened with power. And he wants us to know tonight who is the source of this power. He wants us to know that Christ, he is the source of our power. Because how many of you know that all power in heaven and earth, it belongs to him? Amen. That's what Jesus said. He says, all power in heaven and earth, he says, has been given unto me. And he said that it has been given unto me. And some might say, well, why would Jesus say that all power has been given unto him? Because after all, he is God. He is the eternal God, our Father. But he says all power has been given unto me. Because he's more than God. He is the God-man. He is our mediator. He is our intercessor. And because he is our mediator and because he is our intercessor, he says all power has been given unto me. Amen. And he says in heaven and in earth. Amen. All power, he says, has been given to me in heaven. In other words, he's saying he has all power in heaven. He has all dominion over angels. He has power over angels, church. And because he has all power in heaven, he has the power of intercession. He has intercession with his Father. He has the power of intercession. And so with the power of intercessions, he's able to intercede for you and I. Hallelujah. We can go to him and he prays for us and he intercedes for us because he says all power in heaven has been given unto me. And then he says all power on earth. He has all power not only in heaven, but he has all power in earth. Because he deals with man, having authority over them. Why? Because of the ministry of reconciliation. He has power on earth. Power to reconcile you. Power to redeem you and power to set you free. So he said, I have all power in heaven and I have all power on earth. Hallelujah. And therefore, he has power over all the soul of men. He has power over every one of us. All power and dominion, the Bible says, it belongs to him. He has all power. Hallelujah. And because he has all power, because he has dominion over all flesh, he has power over all flesh. The Bible said there will be a day coming that every tongue will confess him. Every tongue will confess that he's Lord. Every knee shall bow unto him. And every tongue will confess that he is Lord, because he has all power. All power, church, in heaven and earth. And Paul tonight prays for the church. And he prayed that the church be strengthened with his mighty power. It's going to take power for the church to survive in this last day. And so Paul talks about this power of Christ. Listen what he says about it. He said that he is the image of the invisible God, and that he is the firstborn over all creation. That's the power of God. He is the image of this invisible God. He is the creator of the universe. Hallelujah. He was not part of the created order of things. Jesus was not part of God's created order. Amen. In other words, when on the first day when God, he said, let there be light, there was light. Yes. And then on the second day, he created the firmament, and he called it heaven, and that was the second day. He did things in order. But Jesus was not part of that created order. He was the eternal God that created all things and uphold all things by the word of his power. Hallelujah. He was not part of that created order. He was present in the beginning with the Father. Hallelujah. The Bible says in the beginning was the Word. The Word was with God. And the Word was God. All things was made by him. And without him was not anything made that was made. He is the creative power of God. And Paul prayed that you be strengthened with this power. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He said, by him were all things created, in heaven and in earth, visible and invisible. Whether they be thrones or dominions or principles or powers, all things were created by him and for him. For he's before all things, and by him all things consist. Hallelujah. The invisible God, he calls him. But we as believers, even though he is the invisible God, we see who he is, don't we, church? We not only see him as the creator of all things, but we see him as our redeeming Savior, don't we? Hallelujah. Psalms 111:6 says, he has showed his people the power of his work. He sent redemption unto his people. David said, he has showed us. He has showed you and I the power of his work. You can look at one another and you can see the power of God's work. He has redeemed us by the power of his word. He has redeemed us. And he has sent redemption.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Unto his people. And because of this, tonight, we can rejoice. Because of the stability of his work and because of the stability of his word. Because what God has done, he cannot undo. I say what God has done for you, he has redeemed you, he cannot undo it. That's why he said, let the redeemed of the Lord say so. Hallelujah. God can't undo his redemptive work. Because what he did it in truth. And what he did it in his uprightness. And it is the righteousness of God that tendeth to life. Somebody shout, what God has done for me, the devil can't undo it. You've been redeemed, church. Hallelujah. You've been set free. David said, who is likened unto the Lord our God, who dwell, who himself to behold the things, who humbled himself to behold the things that are in heaven and in earth. He raised the poor out of the dust, didn't he? And he lifted the needy out of the dunghill that he might set him with princes. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thought about Joseph when he was tried. And he was manifested. The Bible, he was raised from prison and he was able to sit with princes. Hallelujah. He has made us priests. A royal priesthood. He was able to raise us and to sit us in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. According to his divine power, the Bible says, he has given us all things that pertains to life. It is the power of God.
Thank you, Lord.
The psalmist says that he exalted himself. He exalts himself, and not only he exalts himself, but he humbles himself. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He exalts himself in that his glory is above the heavens. Hallelujah. He humbles himself to behold all his creation.
Yes, Lord. Yes.
For he came from heaven and earth,
yes,
that he might seek and save that which was lost.
Yes.
He humbled himself. Became obedient unto death.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Was made in sinful flesh.
Yes.
And for sin, he condemned sin in the flesh.
Yes,
that you and I might be made the righteousness of God in Christ.
Yes.
He not only exalts himself, church, but he humbles himself.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
He is the mighty God.
Hallelujah.
That we serve today.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Thank you.
Paul goes on and he talks about him.
Yes.
Paul calls him the firstborn from among the dead.
Yes.
Hallelujah. A lot of people misinterpret this. Doesn't mean that Jesus is saying that he's the first from born among the dead, because he was not the first one raised from the dead. Scripture teaches others that was raised from the dead. In fact, Jesus himself raised others from the dead. Lazarus and Jairus' daughter, he raised others from the dead. But Paul is not talking about raising folks from the dead. But he is saying he is the firstborn of all creation. This new creation
in Christ Jesus. He is the firstborn. He is the head of the church. He is the head of the body of Christ. He is the firstborn. Hallelujah. From the dead. And that he might have the preeminence over all things. Paul prays tonight that the church be strengthened with this power. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He says that you be strengthened with might according to his glorious power unto all patience, long suffering, with joyfulness, who has delivered us from the power of darkness. Hallelujah. Translated us unto the kingdom of his dear son. Hallelujah. Be strengthened tonight, church, with this power. Because this power that Paul wants you to be indwelt with, it is the power that changes your heart. It is a power that will change your life. It is a power that will change your attitude. Hallelujah. For it is the power of a risen Savior. Resurrection power. Recreated power from within. Paul said, I pray that you be strengthened with this power from within. You might live the life that God expects you to live. Amen. And he talks about it again. Paul said, then you that were sometime alienated and enemies in your mind by wicked works, yet now he reconciled in the body of his flesh through death. To present you holy and blameless and unreproved in his sight. I believe somebody ought to shout, say, I'm blameless in the sight of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He has reconciled us, church, through the death of Jesus, unleashing unto you and I resurrected power. In order to make us holy. Yes. And in order to make us guiltless before him. Yes. Hallelujah. Thank you. Hallelujah. Thank you. Be thankful tonight that he see you with no sin. Amen. But he see you holy. Hallelujah. He seeing you blameless. Yes. He see you guiltless in his sight. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. And now he is saying to you, that you are my people and I am your God. Yes, Lord. Yes. Hallelujah. That was part of his redemptive plan, that you might call him your Lord, that you might call him your Savior. Yes. Hallelujah. You, hallelujah. That he would present himself a blameless church without spot and without wrinkle. Hallelujah. It is the power of God that Paul prays for, that you be strengthened with tonight. For he said, it is God which worketh in you, both to will and to do his good pleasure. The power of God tonight, church, is Christ in you, the hope of glory, to do his will and for his good pleasure. I pray to you tonight that you be strengthened with this power, that you be strengthened with this power of God, the glory of God, that he indwells you, that causes you to live right, that causes you to walk right, that causes right. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Paul said, I pray that you be strengthened with power. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Be strengthened tonight with might by his glorious power. Hallelujah. 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 And so he says to the church tonight, he said, do all things without murmuring. You have no reason to murmur. Do all things without disputing. You ain't got no business murmuring about nothing. You ain't got no business disputing about nothing. Hallelujah. He said, do it that you might be blameless and harmless. The Son of God without rebuke in the midst of a crooked and perverse nation. Among whom you shine as lights in the world. Hallelujah. 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 He prays that you be strengthened with might. Amen. He wants you to have strength tonight. Said in the word, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might.
Amen.
Hallelujah. He's a saving God tonight. He's a loving God tonight. He just gave me the 5-minute mark, so I'll close it up, but I had a lot more to say. But Psalm talks about the children of Israel and their rebellion against God. The psalmist said, we have sinned with our Father. We have committed iniquity. And he said, we have done wickedly. And the psalmist said, our fathers, they didn't understand the wonders that he did in Egypt. Neither they remembered his multitude of mercy. And the psalmist said they provoked him by the Red Sea. Nevertheless, he saved them for his name's sake. That he might make his mighty power known. Hallelujah. In other words, the psalmist is saying, he saved us.
follows us all the days of our life. We thank you for that that you have made available to every saint of God. Every person that have been born again is entitled to see Jesus. Yeah, we must see him. Do you understand the things of God in the spirit realm? We must see Jesus. Amen. He's not dead. He's alive. Amen. And you and I are his witnesses right here in this present evil world. Amen. We're witness to his death, his burial, and his resurrection. Amen. Because we died with Christ. When Christ died, we died. The believer died. Every believer that believes in Jesus Christ is already dead to sin. All he have to do is continue to believe that. Have faith in God. Trust in God. Trust in his word. Trust in his power. Trust in his glory. Every person that ever gets born again from up above, God has freed him through his son, Jesus Christ, from sin. Sin and death. This new man will not even taste death. He won't know nothing about death. Death has been abolished in the person of the Lord Jesus Christ for every believer. Jesus Christ has abolished death and brought life and immortality to light through the gospel. And that is what God has given us and sent us out to preach, is the gospel of Christ, the gospel of the kingdom of Almighty God. Jesus came to earth to set up a heavenly kingdom right here in the heart of the believer. Amen. So the kingdoms of this world, they don't belong to God, and they're coming down. Amen. Through the gospel that we preach, through your understanding of the word of God, every one of his children that have been born again from up above, they have an understanding heart. He has put a new heart in you, a new heart inside of me. Amen. He has taken the stony heart out of our flesh and put within us an heart of flesh. Amen. Praise God. Father, touch somebody's heart today. Heal, deliver, and set free those that are seeking after Christ. We got to walk in the spirit. We can't walk in the flesh and find God. You have to walk by faith and not by sight. And the just shall live by faith. Come on up, Sister Duff. Talk to us a while. Amen. We know that God has given you something very precious to give to his people. It's called his word. Jesus Christ, being God's word made flesh, dwelt among us, and we have beheld his glory, right? We're beholding Jesus. He's the man in the glory. Amen. Hallelujah.
I might have to give you a little more voice.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. It's a blessing, an honor, and a benediction to be here tonight. That the Lord has given us another day that we can lift up his name and honor him and praise him and speak a word that will bless his people. And he's the one that's given us the word. And I'm going to say this. We got to learn how to talk God's language. We've been saying that for months. We got to speak the language of God and stop speaking the language of the world. And it says here, nowhere does the Bible teach that if you just believe in your heart, you'll get an answer. It teaches that if you believe it with your heart and say it with your mouth, you shall have whatsoever you say. This is one of the secrets of confession. Confession is important. That's why you need to say what the word says. There's power in the word. And what are you saying tonight? What are you confessing? Whatever you are confessing, that is what you are possessing. Because you have what you say. The Bible says that we have what we say. Jesus said, you have what you say. And we have to be very careful what we say. He says, there is no faith without confession. Listen, there is no faith without confession. Did you get it? Say it. There is no faith without confession. All right? It says that with your mouth, you are either going to give God dominion over you, or you're going to give Satan dominion over you. Now, if you speak God's word or speak his language, you're giving him dominion. That's your confession. But if you speak the words of the world or whatever you're feeling or seeing, then that's what you're going to get. You give the devil dominion over you. So it's two powers there. But the devil can't do nothing to God's people without their permission. You've got to say something that's not the language of God in order for the enemy to take dominion. Our confession is so important.
It is, absolutely it is.
He said, you're going to give Satan dominion over you, or you're going to give God dominion over you. Quit talking the devil's language and start talking God's language. as of tonight, said, I am not going to speak the language of the devil. I am going to speak the language of God. And the language of God is the word of God. And I have power in my confession. All right. Now that wasn't hard, was it? Just remember, you got to continue. It's a continuation in making your confession. Believe in your heart. Confess with your mouth. And whatever you believe in your heart, that's what's going to come out of your mouth. Because the Bible said, out of the heart comes the issues of life. And if I believe that God is right and his word is right, then that's what I'm going to speak. Because I want to give God dominion over me. And you should want to give him dominion over you. And over your family. Whatever you speak about your family, that's what will take place. If God's given you power to bless your family, then you need to take the power of that word and bless your family. It makes no difference what they're doing, what they're saying. God has given us power because we're serving him. We're his children, and he's given us the word to pray a blessing on our children. And it will come to pass. You can look in the Bible, in under the old covenant, those men blessed their children. And when they got ready to leave the earth, they called them all in, and they prayed a blessing on them. It didn't say they were doing what they were supposed to do, all of them, but he blessed them. The Father blessed the children. He prayed a blessing. And this is the time, if it ever was a time, it's a time for you to and not curse. So what are you confessing today? Just think about it. This is something the Lord wants you to think about. That. Just that. What are you confessing? What is your confession? Are you confessing the word? Are you confessing unbelief and doubt and fear? It's time for us to speak the word. And I'm gonna give you some. We had some confessions. Do you all remember the Gospels?
Yes.
H- How many still got their Gospels? You know what it said? It said confess them 3 times a day. Now, if you're talking about a powerhouse, if you had from the time that you got these to right now, you'd be a powerhouse of confession, of confessing these words. I mean, the devil couldn't get you to say nothing else, because there's power in the word. And you confess them until they manifest. Manifest means until they show up in your life. Amen? And we need to move in the power at this hour. And it's all going to depend on what we're confessing. What are you confessing? All right. The first confession is for wisdom and guidance. Confess these scriptures daily. For wisdom and guidance. Confess these scriptures daily. The first one is Colossians 3, 9 and 10. I want you to say it after I say it. I do not lie. For I have put off the old man with his deeds, and I have put on the new man, which is renewed in knowledge after the image of him that created him. So we know who that is that created us, don't we? God our Father created us. And so we done put off the old man and his deeds. And we done put on the new man. So now we're walking in true holiness and true righteousness. And then John said, 16 and 13, the Spirit of truth has come. He guides me into all truth. He does not speak of himself. That he hears, that he speaks. And he shows me things to come. See, I'm here tonight speaking that I do know. Nothing else, nothing more, nothing less. Just speaking what God has shown me. And what is being fulfilled in me. And whatever you've got, you can give it. If you haven't got it, you can't give it. You can't give something you haven't got. Amen. Now, you can get up and you can tell people about holiness. You can tell people about righteousness and all. And if you don't have it, you're just blowing in the wind. It doesn't mean anything. But God will show people the results of what you're saying in your life. He will show it. Amen. Okay, Proverbs 3, 5, and 6. I trust in the Lord with all my heart, and I lean not unto my own understanding. In all my ways, I acknowledge him, and he directs my path. Is that true? That's a powerful confession. And if you are doing that, making that confession, then it's fulfilling your life. Thank you, Jesus. What are you confessing today? What is your confession? Is it the word of God? Or is it the words of the world? The power of God is in the word of God. And he is opening up the word to us tonight. And we are testifying to what we have received from the Lord. And in that word, he also was showing me, as I begin to look at these confessions, he was showing me the healing power of this word. The word, he sent his word and he healed us from all of our diseases and all of our distresses. He sent his word and healed us. Who is the word? Jesus. Jesus is the word of God. And he came and he lived and he healed the sick and he raised the dead and he gave sight to the blind. And the lame got up and walked. And the deaf heard. The power of the word. Because he was the word. And now he's making us in his image. And in his likeness. That we will go and speak the word. Only learning to speak the language of God. This is God's word that we're talking about tonight. And it is God. Because God sent Jesus. He wrapped himself as a matter of truth. God wrapped himself up in that little flesh. And came down to this earth. To save man. He had that plan before the foundation of the world. Because he knew all what was going to happen with man. He knows the end from the beginning. And he knows the beginning from the end. That's the word, the power of the word. And he spoke it. He spoke those things that were not as though they were. And they came to pass. And this is the hour now where we're coming into. Speaking those things that are not as though they were. And they are. Amen. I'm talking about a power of healing. I'm talking about what confession are you making today? Speaking the language of God. This is what we're supposed to do. And the language of God is this word here. Not what we think. Not what somebody told us. But what God told us. And he backs it up with his word. We can be assured that what we're speaking is God's language. When it comes out of the word. Healing is the children's bread. God sent healing to us. Jesus took the stripes on his back for our healing. They beat him unmercifully. And he said, "Why don't you believe what I've done for you? Why don't you say what I say? Why don't you believe me? Why don't my people believe me? And make the right confession." I hear so many times we say, we're changing our language. But we've got to do it. It's time to start fixing to do something and do it. God is in the now. Now faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. He moves in the now. And faith, your confession, brings faith. It's power. You can believe all you want to, but if you never make a confession, then your faith won't work. Believe in your heart and confess with your mouth. Believe in your heart and confess with your mouth. This is the word. What are you confessing? Are you confessing blessing? Are you confessing healing? Are you confessing deliverance? God's people making the wrong confession. Oh, I'm so sick. You hear what you say. It doesn't seem like much. But you have the power of your Father in your mouth, in your tongue. And when you say something, it's going to take place. We got to realize who we are in Christ Jesus. What authority we have. And speak it. Speak the word only. Speak the word only. Make your confession the language of God. We're in the hour where we need to speak the word more than we've ever spoken before. It doesn't make no difference to me what people think about me. It really doesn't. Wherever he tells me to pray for somebody, I'm going to pray for him. And you know, a lot of people appreciate that. Maybe some don't, but it doesn't really matter. It doesn't really matter. Those that believe will receive and get what they ask for. Making the right confession. Power in your word. See, it doesn't take a whole lot. Just use what you got. So, I want a whole lot of faith like so-and-so, sister so-and-so, or brother so-and-so. Use what you got. And it'll increase. If God's given you something, use it. Don't let the devil tell you that you ain't got nothing. Use it. Speak it. Don't be afraid. God didn't give you the spirit of fear, but power. Power of the Holy Ghost. Love. The love of God. And that sound mind is the mind of Christ. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for your word. Thank you for your power. Thank you for the authority. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for your healing. Thank you, Jesus. We believe and we receive. We confess and we possess. And now it's time to take back that the enemy has stolen away from you. Then he said there would come a time that the enemy was going to have to give up. Well, we got to speak it. He ain't going to give up until we speak it. When we start speaking with the authority that God has given us in the name of Jesus, it's going to happen. It's taking place right now in the atmosphere. The angels are going and setting people free. Binding up the brokenhearted. Setting at liberty those that are bruised. Because we're preaching the acceptable year of the Lord. And it's here now. It's here now. Healing is here now for you. And deliverance is here now for you. All you got to do is step in the water. Step in the water. It's being trouble. It's trouble tonight. And all you got to do is step in. And you'll be healed. From the crown of your head to the soles of your feet. Right out to the ends of your fingertips and your toe tips. The power of God is moving. It's moving in the atmosphere. He's bringing healing to souls. He's saving souls. He's binding up your heart. He's setting at liberty those that are bruised. The Spirit of God. Like he moved in the beginning on the face of the deep. And he stepped out and he said, let there be light. And some say he said, light be. And it was. Well, he's saying the same thing now. Light be. And it is. Salvation for those that need salvation. Deliverance for those that need deliverance. Healing for those that need healing. And those that been hurt years and years and years and haven't forgiven, you got to forgive. People of God, you got to forgive. It's healing. It's a healing balm in forgiving. You set yourself free. You set yourself free. It's power in forgiving. It makes no difference what somebody has done to you. Jesus looked out over the people when he was hanging on the cross and all that they did to him. And he said, Lord, forgive them, for they know not what they do. You got to say the same thing. Lord, forgive them, for they know not what they do. It's time to gird up your loins and walk as people of God. Be that light that God called you to be. And confess the right thing. The world is looking for the manifestation of the sons of God. And it's time for the sons to manifest. And how will you manifest? With your mouth. Saying who you are. Not being ashamed to say you are a son of God. And I have been made the righteousness of God in Christ. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. It's time to move out. Move out. Move up. Time is winding up. Perilous times are here. Men are lovers of themselves more than they are of God. You can look around tonight and see, where are the people? Where are the people? Thank you, Jesus. We love the Lord. We love the Lord with all our heart. And we're going to walk in his way. We're going to confess the right confession. And we're going to bless his people. Because he told us to bless and curse not. Yes, he did. He told us to bless and curse not. And that's exactly what we're doing. Grace is here, church. You know who grace is? You know what grace's name is? Jesus. Jesus. He's here. He's here. He's moving. He's moving. He's healing the sick. He's healing somebody right now. You know what he showed me? He said, if you'll speak what I tell you to speak, he said, I'll move on my people in a miraculous way. I'll put my hands on them. They won't need no flesh to touch them. The power of my word is going to do it. And that's what he's doing right now. Amen. From this night forth, things going to be different in your home, Mother Porter. Word from the Lord. From this night forth, it's going to be a change in your home. God's stirring the nest. He heard your prayers. He's seen your tears. And he's come to see about you. Yes, he is. He's moving right now. Yes, he is. He's healing the sick. He's raising the dead. Those that are dead in trespasses and sin. He told us that's what we would do. We're going to do greater works than these, he said. What were the great works? He came, he was raising the dead. But he was saying, we're going to raise the spiritual dead. And the spiritual lame. And the spiritual death. That word is going to go out and grab them. Open up their deaf ears. They're going to hear the voice of God for the first time. And they're going to be able to walk towards him. And they're going to have the love in their heart. Because he's putting it there. The word has come. The word has come. to deliver you. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. 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 Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Sissy, that's getting ready to come, a turnaround in your life. A turnaround. Great power and glory is coming to your home. God is going to move in a miraculous way because you love him and you're seeking him. He said, continue to pray. Continue to believe. And hold on to the horns of the altar. Don't give up. He said, I'm moving for you. I've come to see about you. I know what you're going through. I'm right there with you. I'll never leave you nor forsake you. Just believe it. Just believe it. Just believe it. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. He's healing you too. He's healing your body. Thank you, Jesus. 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 Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. 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 Oh, Father, we thank you. We thank you for your word, Lord Jesus. We thank you for your word. We thank you for sending your word and healing us from all of our diseases and all of our distresses. Oh, we're yours, Lord. We surrender all. All to you we surrender. Thank you, Jesus. 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 Brother Benny. Come on. Thank you, Jesus. 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 The Lord said to tell you some things you've been praying about. You ain't told nobody. But you've been believing and trusting. He says, coming to pass. Just don't give up. Hold on. He said, he's there with you. He'll never leave you nor forsake you. Amen. He said, just rejoice. Rejoice. And make the right confession. Woo! Glory. Thank you, Lord. Come on, brother. You got something you want to share with us tonight? Thank you, Jesus. 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 It's going to be a change here at this place, he said. It may not seem like it, but you're going to see little by little changes in our little place here. Amen. You're going to see the power of God moving in miraculous ways like you've never seen it here before. So just look for it. It's going to happen. Amen. Because I'm speaking what he's telling me. What I hear him say, that's what I'm saying. What I see him do, that's what I'm going to do. Amen. From this night forth, you can say, Sister Duff going crazy. Well, I am a fanatic for Jesus. And I'm going to do what he tell me to do, when he tell me to do it, and how he tell me to do it. Amen. Give Jesus a hand clap. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Just continue on and got with a little